Welcome back, children. I'm your maths teacher, Miss Nutan Tiwari, and today we will start with exercise 4.1 of lesson number 4, Basic Geometrical Ideas. Question number 1 is, use the figure to name 5 points, a line, 4 rays and 5 line segments. Children, before starting to solve this sum, we will just revise these four terms, that is point, line, ray and a line segment. Children, what is a point? Point is a dot which determines a location. Then what is a line? A line has no end points. It can be extended from either of its end points. Now what is a line segment? A line segment has two end points. It cannot be extended from any of its end points. And now children, last one is ray. What is a ray? A ray has one end point, that is one starting point or initial point, and it goes endlessly in a direction. You can say, children, that a ray is a portion of a line. Now we will start solving this sum. Now children, we will find out the 5 points in this figure. So you can see here, the 5 points in this figure are point O, point B, point C, point D and point E. Now children, we have to find out a line in this figure. Children, here the answers can be many. So the first line which you can find in this figure is line DB. Now the other lines are line DE, line EO and line OB. I will repeat, children, the lines are line DE, line DB, line OE and line OB. Now children, rays in this figure. So rays in this figure are ray OD, ray OE, ray OC and ray OB. Children, I'll repeat, the four rays in this figure are ray OD, ray OE, ray OC and ray OB. Now children, the line segments in this figure. The line segment in this figure are line segment DE, line segment OE, line segment OC, line segment OB and line segment OD. Once again, children, see the line segments in the figure. Line segment DE, line segment OE, line segment OC, line segment OB and line segment OD. Now children, question number 2. Name the line given in all possible ways, that is 12 ways. In this question, you have to name the line in 12 ways, choosing only 2 letters at a time from the 4 given. The 4 points which are given are A, B, C and D. Using these 4 points, we have to name the line and we have to choose only 2 letters at a time. So children, let's start doing this sum. So children, here are 12 lines which are named from points A, B, C and D. Children, you can see the points, point A, B, C and D on the line. So children, lines formed are line AB, line AC, line AD, line BC, line BD, line CD, line BA, line CA, line DA, line CB, line DB and line DC. Now children, question number 3, use the figure to name. Children, you have to see the figure and you have to answer the questions which are given, that is line containing point E, line passing through A, line on which O lies and two pairs of intersecting lines. So children, observe the figure and answer the following questions. The first one is a line containing point E. Children, line containing point E are line AE and line FE.
There are two lines which contain point E. Then the next question is line passing through A. Children, the line passing through point A are line AE and line DE. Now the next one is line on which O lies. So children, in the figure you can see that O lies on line CO or line OC. And the last one is two pairs of intersecting lines. So here children, two pairs of intersecting lines are line AD and line CO, and another pair is line AE and line FE. So children, we will just take a quick look, revise this answer. A line containing point E is line AE or line FE. A line passing through A is line AE or line DE. A line on which point O lies is line CO or line OC. And last one, two pairs of intersecting lines are line AD, line CO, and line AE, line FE. Now question number 4, how many lines can pass through one given point and how many lines can pass through two given points? Children, in my last video I explained you that if one point is given, many lines can pass through one given point. That means infinite lines can pass through one given point. But if two points are given, then here you can see in the figure that infinite number of lines can pass through one given point and only one line can pass through two given points. Now the next question is, draw a rough figure and label suitably in each of the following cases. So children, now you have to draw a figure according to the instructions given. The first one is point P lies on line segment AB. So children, in this figure you can see that line segment AB is given and point P is between point A and B, that is line segment AB. Now the next figure which you have to draw is XY and PQ intersect at M. So children, here you can see that line XY and PQ is made and M is the point of intersection. Or you can say this also, that M is the common meeting point of line XY and line PQ. Now children, see, line L contains E and F but not D. So here in this picture you can see that line L is drawn and there are two points on line L, that is E and F. And D is a point which is outside the line L. Now the last figure which you have to draw is line OP and line OQ meet at point O. So children, in this figure you can see that line OQ and OP is drawn but their intersection point is O. That means their common meeting point is O. Now children, last question of this exercise is, consider the following figure of line MN. See whether following statements are true or false in context of the given figure. So children, here 11 statements are given to you and you have to see the figure which is given to you and accordingly you have to find out that these statements are true or false. So the first statement is Q, M, O, N, P are points on the line MN. Children, this statement is a true statement. Children, just observe the figure in question number 6 on page number 75. See line MN. Line MN, if extended from point M and point N, we have Q and P as two points. So this statement is a true statement that Q, M, O, N, P are points on the line MN and O is a point in the middle of line MN. Now the next statement is M, O, N are points on line segment MN. This is also a true statement because children, M and N are two end points of line segment MN and O is a midpoint of line segment MN. Now, next statement, M and N are end points of line segments MN. Yes, children, this statement is also a true statement because line segment MN means the two end points are M and N. So, this statement is also a true statement. Now, the next one is O and N are end points of line segment OP. This statement is a false statement because children, if line segment OP, then it has two end points, that is O and P. So, this statement is false because O and N are not end points of line segment OP. Instead, O and P are end points of line segment OP. Now, the fifth one is M is one of the end points of line segment QO. Children, this is also a false statement because M is the midpoint of line segment QO. It is not the end point of line segment QO. The end points of line segment QO are Q and O. Now the next one is M is a point on ray OP. Okay children, so now M is a point on ray OP. This is a false statement because N is the point on ray OP. Now the next statement is ray OP is different from ray QP. Children, this is a true statement because children, you can see in the figure in ray OP, O is the starting point and in ray QP, Q is the starting point. Now the next one is ray OP is same as ray OM. Children, this is a false statement because both the rays, that is ray OP and ray OM, are two different rays. Now children, next is ray OM is not opposite to ray OP. Children, this is a false statement because ray OM is opposite to ray OP. You can see in the figure. Now the next one is O is not an initial point of ray OP. Children, this is a false statement. What is the meaning of initial point? Initial point means starting point. So, O is the initial point of ray OP and this statement is a false statement. Now, children, the last one, N is the initial point of ray NP and ray NM. Yes, this statement is a true statement. Children, you can see in the figure ray NP and ray NM and N is only the initial point of both the rays, that is ray NP and ray NM. N is the starting point of ray NP and ray NM. Children, just write down the homework. You have to find out some examples of point, line, line segment, ray, parallel lines and intersecting lines from your surroundings. Children, you will find some things around you which resemble these geometrical figures. So please do this homework. We will meet in my next video. Till then, stay connected. Bye-bye.